Hi, this is Srinivas Lakyam. Today we are going to discuss main method. What is main method? Do you have any idea? Main method, every Java program execution starts from main method. Main method plays very important role in Java. So syntax of main method is public void main, public static, void main. It takes one argument, string array, args. So this is the syntax of main method. So this argument takes command line arguments. If you want to pass any arguments to Java program through command line, each and every command line pass to this array. Example, assume this is class A. Class test. In this test we have main method, and after compilation we get dot class file, right? When you compile this program by using Java C test.java, we will get dot class file called test.class. So we compile this program by using command called Java and class name. So this is the way we compile execute our Java program. So when we execute any Java program, execution starts from main method. It means every standalone or every core Java application execution starts from where? Main method. So standalone application life cycle starts from where? Main method. So here if you want to pass any command line arguments, we pass those command line arguments here. We give space and we pass command line arguments. Assume I want to pass two values, 10, 20. So these two values are stored into string array. Okay. So for our program, if you want to pass any command line arguments, while running our application, we pass command line arguments. Each and every command line argument stores into string array. Okay. Next, why Java main method is public? Can we take main method as private? No, we cannot take main method as private. If you take main method as private, that main method available only within the class. Outside the class we cannot access. It means we cannot call main method outside the class. So if you want to class main method from outside of our class, method should be public. Here when we run this program, it invokes what? JVM. JVM calls this test class. In this test class it is calling what? Main method. If main method is private, JVM cannot call main method directly. That's why main method should be public. And why main method is static? Do you have any idea why main method is static? See, when we run any Java program, what will happen? There is one static area in JVM, static area or static context. We call this as static context. When we run any Java program, first it will load all static variables, all static variables and static methods. Static methods into this static context. JVM loads all static variables, static methods into this context. See, in this program we have only one static method. In this class we have only static method. What is the main method? Then once it is loaded into static area, static context, then JVM calls in that among variables and methods, it will call what? Main method. Because every Java program execution starts from main method. So to load this method into static context area, we used static keyword. So when we run any Java program, initially it reads all static variables and static methods from this class and loads into where? Static context. Then execution starts from main method. And why main method is? Why main method is void? See, here we are calling Java, we are running our Java class, right? So it means it invokes what? This command invokes JVM. Then JVM reads this class and calling what? Main method. So JVM calling main method, it is not expecting any value from main method. That's why if any method not return any value, if any method not returns any value, then method return type should be void. So if you call any method, if that method not returns any value, then we define that method as void. Void means nothing. It means this method returning nothing. Okay, so why main method is public? To access this method outside of this class. Why main method is static? So initially all static variables and static method loads into static area. So to load main method into static area, we define static main method as static. Then why main method return type is void? Main method is not returning any value. That's why we define main method as void. So what is the purpose of this argument? This argument takes command line arguments. Okay, so this is the syntax of Java class. Let's see one simple program. See, I have one method, main method, and in this main method I am printing one message, system dot out dot println. So I am printing message hello. I am writing one more method called public static void, and my method name is main, and I am taking string array args, and here I am printing some message system dot out dot println different main method. Different main method. Can you tell me, can we take more than one main method in our class? Can we take or not? See, initially we discussed identifiers. In identifiers, we can take any class name or method name. Right, identifier means class name or method name or variable name. So if you observe identifier rules, there is one rule, one important rule. Java is case sensitive. Java is case sensitive. What is the meaning of this statement? Lowercase letters and uppercase letters are different, right? So Java is case sensitive. Based on these cases, Java differentiate these two methods. So when you run any Java program, it invokes what? JVM. JVM search for only lowercase main method which takes string array. So whether you define multiple main methods or not, it will, JVM searches for main method with lowercase letters which takes string array as argument. So when you run our program, it executes only what? This main method, but not this main method. And I am taking one more main method, public static void main, and I am taking different argument, int array args. In this I am printing system.out.println int main method. Okay, I have three main methods. One is it takes string array as argument, and another one is it takes integer array as argument, and another one is different main method because this case is different. This main method case is different. This is completely in uppercase. So can we take same method name with different arguments? So in overloading, we can take multiple methods with the same name but different arguments. So this is called what? Overloading. Method name is same, but different arguments. Here string array, here integer array. Method name is same with different arguments is called overloading. It means we can implement overloading in our class. So here when we run our class, is it executes this main method or is it executes this main method? Which one it executes? So JVM always calls main method which takes string array as arguments. When you run your Java program, first it will load static methods. Here we have three static main methods, but among these three static main methods, JVM always executes main method which takes as what? String array as argument. Okay, so execution starts from this one. My question is here, how do we call this main method? Is JVM calls this method? JVM calls only this method. It will not call this method. If you want to call this method, you can call like a normal method call. So I want to call this method. So here you can call main and pass integer array. So this method calls like normal method. This is not life cycle method. This will call automatically, but if you want to call this method, you can call manually or we can call this manually. So it will not call automatically. JVM always calls main method, which takes as string array as argument. Okay. So if you want to call this method, you can call this method manually. Hi, this is Srinivas Lakhim. Today we are going to discuss coding standards in Java. What is coding standards? Coding standards are naming conventions in Java. It is not mandatory to follow coding standards, but it is highly recommended to follow. It is optional, but highly recommended to follow. See, let's see some coding standards. Java class name. Java class name. R interface name. Interface name or enum name. Every Java class name should start with uppercase letter. Every Java class name should start with uppercase letter. Every Java class name should start with what? Uppercase name. Same as interface name also. Every interface name also should start with uppercase name. Enum. So every class name or every interface name or every enum name should start with uppercase letter. But it is optional. Instead of caps, we can also take lower case. Test. But this approach is not recommended. This approach is not recommended. This approach is recommended. So we can take every class first letter should be what? Uppercase letter. Okay. If class contain multiple words like student details, class student details. If class contain multiple words, each inner word first character should be uppercase. Okay. So if class contain only one word, first letter should be uppercase. If class contain multiple words, each inner word name should be uppercase. Every predefined class in Java follows same rules, so that we can easily identify this. If you see any name in Java, we can identify whether it is a class or method or variable. So by seeing name itself, we can easily identify this is a class. Okay. If you see runnable, runnable, this is a capital letter. This is predefined interface. If you see system, system is a predefined class. S is a capital letter. So when you see any predefined class name, when you see any predefined interface name, every predefined class first letter is uppercase. Every predefined interface first letter is uppercase. So predefined classes developed by Sun Microsystem followed this approach. So if you follow, we can easily identify whether it is a class or not. Okay. So these are important, but these are optional. So what is the coding standards for Java variables? Java variables. Coding standards for Java variables. So every variable name should be lower case. Every variable name should be lower case. So every variable name should be what? Lowercase letter. If variable name contain multiple words, if variable name contain multiple words, every inner word letter should be what? Uppercase. See, string, first name. If variable contain multiple words, every inner word name should be uppercase. Next, if variable is constant variable should be a uppercase name. Int max underscore max, max value. So the max is a fixed value. So every constant variable name should be what? Uppercase letter. Entire word should be uppercase. If constant variable contain multiple words like int max value, assume if constant variable contain multiple words, each word separated with underscore. So constant variable name should be max underscore value. So every variable is lowercase, every variable name is lowercase. If variable contain multiple words, every inner word first letter should be what? Uppercase letter. If you define any constants in Java, every constant name should be uppercase, entire word should be uppercase. If constant variable name contain multiple words, each word separated with underscore. Okay. Next, coding standards for methods. Coding standards for methods. Method naming convention follows same as variables. For example, I have a method with a single word name, M1. So method name is lowercase. If your method contain multiple words, void student details. So every inner word first letter should be uppercase. First word first letter is complete, first word is lowercase. If method name contain multiple words, every inner word should be what? Uppercase. So naming convention of method follows what? Same as variable names. Okay. Next, coding standards for Pojo class. Pojo stands for plain old Java object. Coding standards for Pojo class. Pojo class should be public class student. So first rule is Pojo class means normal class, normal Java class. Pojo class should be public class. So first rule is Pojo class should be public class. And second important rule is Pojo class should not be abstract class. Pojo class should not be abstract class. So second important rule is POJO class should not be abstract class. Should not be abstract class. So POJO class should not be abstract class. So we cannot define abstract for POJO classes. Next important rule is every variable inside a POJO class should define with a private keyword. Private int SNO. Sorry. Private string sname. So every variable inside a POJO class should be what? Private. Private variable. And so third rule is every variable or property should be defined as private. Next important rule, every variable should have two methods, setter and getter methods. Every variable should have two methods. Every property should have two methods. One is setter and another one is getter method. Okay, if you define variables inside a POJO class, every variable should have setter method and getter method. So I'm writing setter, set SNO, and every setter method should have argument of same type. Every setter method should have argument of same type. In this setter method, we write logic to assign value to this variable. And every setter method must be public and should be written void. So every setter method follows these rules. Every setter method must be public and should return void, and every setter method name start with what? Variable name. Set and variable name. And every setter method must take same type of variable. And we write getter method, get SNO. This getter method not takes any argument. So setter method takes what? Argument. Setter method takes argument, but it doesn't take argument. And setter method return type should be variable type. Setter method return type should be variable type. And getter method return type should be variable type, and getter method must be public. So every getter method follows with variable name, and every getter method return type should be variable type, and every getter method should be public type, and it should return what? Variable value. Return SNO. So if you take any variable, if you define any variable in POJO class, this variable should be what? Private type. In every POJO class, variable type should be private, and every variable has one setter method and one getter method. Setter method takes argument, getter method doesn't take argument. setter method return type should be void, getter method return type should be variable type. Whether it may be setter method, whether it may be getter method, every method should be public method. Public method. Okay? So, and one more important point, one more very very important point. Very very important point. If your class doesn't have any constructor, no issue. Assume your class has constructor. Assume your class has constructor student and it takes int a. Constructor name should be what? Class name. Constructor name should be class name. If your Pojo class contain any constructor other than no argument constructor or default constructor, very important rule. If your class has constructor, if Pojo class has constructor, other than no arg or default constructor, other than no arg or default constructor. It means if you define a constructor with argument or some other constructor, one argument or multiple arguments. So if you define any constructor other than no argument or default constructor, so you have to write one no argument constructor. You have to write one no argument constructor. So it is recommended to write no argument constructor. So if any Pojo class, if you define constructor without other than no argument or default constructor in your Pojo class, if you define other than no argument and default constructor, then you have to write one no argument constructor. It is coding standard. Okay, so these are the rules we need to follow while writing Pojo classes.